It's hard to go past a classic cheese jaffle, which for many Aussies brings back those happy childhood memories. But these days, a gourmet lunch, dinner, or even dessert can be pressed in a matter of minutes.
Jaffles have always been a family favourite. There's something so comforting about them.
I know, as soon as the weather turns cold, we start making them, but sometimes we get a bit stuck in the same old, same old. So I'm going to show you four ways to make jaffles today that you might not have thought of, starting from the savoury, working all the way through to the sweet.
Tell me if you wanna, 'cause I got this feeling.
Jane, your classic cheese jaffle, everybody loves it. What is the secret to getting it perfect?
Okay, so I have four very important tips that will just take it next level for you. The first one is just use normal sliced bread. Store-bought is fine because it fits into your jaffle maker properly. Second tip, butter the outside of your bread. What that does is it crisps up on the outside. I like to use three kinds of cheese. So I always go for a sweet, a creamy, and a nice bitey cheese. Put some bacon on the outside of your sandwich. What you're doing is you're letting the machine cook the bacon for you. You pop it in first, pop the bread on top, it sticks to the bread, and you get a bacon cheese toasty that will blow your mind.
So we have crispy bacon and a cheese jaffle. What could be better?
And trust me, the whole family loves it.
Jane is also using leftover bolognese to make the ultimate minced jaffle.
If you've got leftover pasta sauce and you can't be bothered cooking the pasta, it all works really well in a jaffle. All you need to do is add some cheese, and this time I'm going to butter the outside with mayonnaise, which will crisp it up the same way the butter does, but gives it a little bit of a different flavour.
Jane, that was so quick and easy. What a great option for lunch or school lunch.
And wait till you see what they look like inside. You can see all the bolognese and the cheese is melted. Oh, so good. Stay in the kitchen cooking up,
get your own bread. Aussies have also been getting creative with their jaffle makers, using puff pastry instead of bread.
One of the things that's going viral at the moment is spinach and cheese triangles. For that, I'm going to need some sour cream, some cream cheese, our classic packet French onion soup. I'm gonna mix that all together with our chopped up spinach, pop it in the pastry, into the jaffle maker for 7 minutes. Get that ring,
just like Toronto. Oh wow, Jane, I cannot resist a spinach and cheese triangle. That looks amazing. With just one touch. Now, I've been seeing sweet jaffles online. This is very exciting. What are we making here?
Okay, so this grew out of a social media trend where people were getting Freddo frogs, putting them in pastry or bread and toasting them in the jaffle maker. But then it stepped up a level and people started doing it with caramello koalas. I'm going to take it next level again, and I'm using some sweet brioche bread. We're just going to pop it into our jaffle maker. We're going to add our caramello koalas. And then all we need to do is put another piece on top, close it up for 7 minutes, and you will have the most decadent caramel chocolate sweet jaffle.
Jane, I can't wait any longer. Need to tuck into this.
It's very hot, be careful, but it's delicious.
That really lives up to all expectations.
And it's just a couple of minutes.
Oh, oh, that last one is an
absolute game changer.
I kind of want to tell my kids about it, but I kind of don't.
I kind of want to get off the vegan bandwagon and smash one of those. That's
Do it.
Only thing that's tempted me in years.
That'll get you there.